So in the previous video, we saw what technologies we are going to use in the front-end web development part. So let's start with the HTML structure here. HTML structure starts and ends with an HTML tag, and it has a head tag and a body tag inside it, which is basically two sections. And the head tag contains all the titles inside it, that is basically the name of the website, which displays on the tabs. And inside body tag, we have different types of h tag, which is h1, h2, h3, h4 and h5 and h6, which are according to their size and importance. Also, there are paragraph tags inside it. So let's make a new folder on our desktop. New folder, which has name Professor Hub. And just change its position so it will look more nicer here. And so let's open our Atom text editor, which we downloaded in the previous video. Cut out all these tabs from here by pressing the X icon. Also go to File, now click on the Add Project folder. Go to your desktop and click on the Professor Hub folder, select folder. So now right click on this folder and make a new folder here. No, make a new file here. That is index.html. The extension will be .html, so our text editor know what kind of file it is. So let's start writing our code here. As I told you earlier, HTML file starts with an HTML tag. So let's add HTML tag here. And after entering some spaces here, let's add the enclosing tag of our HTML here, which is a slash here. Okay. Inside this, all our HTML code will be present. So let's make a new tag, that is, let's make it head section, right? And let's add a title here. Also remove this extra spaces from here, we don't need that. Also remove this extra smaller than arrow. So head tag is not an self-enclosing tag, you will need an enclosing tag after the head tag starts. So let's make a body tag here. Body tag is also not an self-enclosing tag. So now let's move on to our head section and let's write and let's use title tag here. Let's cancel out the default text from here. We write this between these two arrows. The text we write between these two arrows will be displayed on our window, which is our web page. So let's write here. Let's write Professor Hub. Professor Hub. And let's cancel out the extra spaces from here. Also title to not an self-enclosing tag, we also need an enclosing tag for our title tag. So let's move on to our body tag and let's add h tag to it. H has different variations, that is h1, h2, h3, h4 and h5 and h6. So the importance reduces as the number of our h increases. So basically h1 is the greatest size and h6 of the smallest size. So let's add h1 here. And let's add some text between this both arrows. Hey, I'm heading 1. Okay. So now let's save a file and just click on it and right click on the index.html and just copy the full path from here. Go into your browser, maximize it and paste it in your search bar. So basically we are gonna access the local disk C and we are gonna go to user. The name of the user is Lenovo and we are gonna go to desktop here, and then we are gonna access the professor folder. Inside that we are gonna access the index.html file. So let's hit enter here. Boom, here we got our text. Here I am heading one. So let's minimize it. Okay, let's just split our screen so it will be easier for you to understand both the results simultaneously. So let's add h2 to it. Okay, so this was the h1, right? It is of a bit bigger size. What if we wanted a text of smaller size? So let's add h2 here. I am heading 2. So let's save our file and refresh the browser. It is also not a self-enclosing tag. Refresh it. We got a smaller size than the h1. So now let's write h3. What if we wanted a smaller size than the h2 too? So right here, I am heading 3 with an h3 tag. I am heading 3. Save it. Refresh it. Look, we got a much smaller size of our text. So let's add h4 here. As you see right now, the font size of our text gradually decreases as our number h1, as our hn increases, that is h1, h2, h3, h4, h5 and h6. So let's simultaneously add h5 and h6 too. Here I am heading 6, here I am heading 5. Let's write our h here. And here we will go with h6. Here I am heading 6. Okay. So let's save it and refresh it. Here I am heading 6 is almost negligible. So what if we wanted a paragraph tag? Like what if we wanted to write those paragraphs and a normal paragraph font size? For that we use a p tag, which is a paragraph tag. So let's write p here. I am paragraph 1. Okay, paragraph line 1. Okay, refresh it. You got a normal text size. So what if we wanted and some more lines on our paragraph tag? So let's write another line. I am paragraph line 2. Save it and just refresh it. As you see, these both the lines are not on different lines, as we want them on the different lines because it is line 1 and line 2. For that we use a self-enclosing tag, that is br, which is line break tag. Add a br tag here, br, and hit enter. So let's save it. Simply save it and refresh it. Look guys, we got this. I am paragraph line 2 on the another line. In this video we saw about h1s and paragraph tags. So I will see you in the next video regarding the images and anchor tags. Bye bye.